अगर दुश्मन है, अगर दुश्मन
दुश्मन
जमाना, गम नहीं गम नहीं। है अगर दुश्मन
दुश्मन
जमाना, गम नहीं गम नहीं। कोई आए कम नहीं कम नहीं। है अगर दुश्मन
दुश्मन
जमाना, गम नहीं।
कोई आए कोई हम किसी से कम नहीं कम नहीं।
है अगर दुश्मन
दुश्मन जमाना, गम नहीं।
है अगर दुश्मन
दुश्मन
जलन को इस मोहब्बत के चलन को, जो भी हो जाए के अब तो सरस बांधा है कफन को। हम तो दीवाने दिल जले, जुल्म के साए में पले। डाल कर आंखों को तेरे रुखसारों पे, रोज ही चलते हैं हम तो अंगारों पे।
की फिल्म हम किसी से कम नहीं से गाना अभी आपने सुना, जिसमें म्यूजिक दिया था आरडी बर्मन साहब ने और आवाज आपने सुनी मोहम्मद रफी की। और आज बॉलीवुड रिवाइंड इज आरडी बर्मन स्पेशल। कुछ देर पहले हमने जाना कि आरडी बर्मन के संगीत में किस तरह से वो एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन से कई गाने ले आते थे, और आशा भोसले के साथ भी मिलकर उन्होंने क्लासिकल रेंडिशंस पेश किए हैं हिंदी फिल्म इंडस्ट्री में। अब जानते हैं और कई खास बातें उनके बारे में आदित्य से।
यू नो हेमंत, कुछ बातें खास हो जाती है बिकॉज दे आर सो मिस्टीरियस एंड हिंदी फिल्म इंडस्ट्रीज ट्रिविया इज फिल्ड विद सच मिस्ट्रीज। वन such mystery was why R.D. Burman didn't favor a singer like Mohammad Rafi, but instead favored Kishore Kumar. Halaki, Rafi Saab had sung for R.D. Burman for movies like Tisri Manzil and many others, which were super hits. But yet, there were very few songs that Rafi Saab sang for R.D. Burman. I suppose it was the change of culture that made R.D. choose Kishore than Rafi. Jaise Javed Akhtar saab ne ek bar kaha tha that Rafi saab's voice had the texture of a town boy, whereas Kishore Kumar's voice had the texture of an urban boy. 70s ka daur dekhe, India was changing quite rapidly, and I suppose R.D. Burman thought that the songs that he's composing Kishore's voice suits these songs the best. But when he chose to compose a Qawwali in Raag Kalavati, which is quite rare and unique in itself, kyunki Qawwali generally is based on raags which are lighter in its nature, Kalavati is not. And because he wanted alaps at the start of the song, he couldn't think of anyone else but Mohammad Rafi. And as audiences, we loved that song.
That's interesting, Aditya. But in the conversation, aapne kaha ki 70s mein India was changing rapidly. Yes, definitely, ye to sab jante hi hain. Magar uska asar music par bhi pada aur aise, like, that's something quite interesting.
Jaise hum folk music ke baare mein jab baat karte hain, we say folk music is people's music. Okay. Similarly, when you talk about music in Hindi film industry or any kind of popular music, the reason it's popular is because it's popular amongst people. So obviously people and society and the changing face of society will have a huge impact and influence on the music that is being created. Having said that, look at music from a global perspective or from an Indian perspective. You will see, unless it's classical, rest all other forms of music change in its texture, tonality, sound every 10 years. It's like a circle. 10 saal ke baad, gaanon ka dhang, gaanon ke lyrics. And because the sound and the nature of music changes, musicians also change. Because it's quite stupid for us to expect the same musician to really keep up with the times and be at top of it for more than 20 or 30 years. And that's also a very, very long journey that we're talking about. So when we look at the 50s ka dashak dekhte hain, you have music composers like Shankar Jaikishan and Naushad Ji. And 60s, we see music duos like Lakshmikant Pyarelal and Kalyan Ji Anand Ji. And S.D. Burman was there in both 50s and 60s. It was here where R.D. Burman's era started. And his direct competition actually was Madan Mohan Saab and his own father, S.D. Burman. Because Naushad Ji, Sri Ramchandra, Shankar Jaikishan were kind of fading away in 60s. O.P. Nayyar Saab was not really giving hit songs like what he used to do back then in late 50s and early 60s. So when you're competing against musicians like S.D. Burman and Madan Mohan Saab and Lakshmikant Pyarelal and Kalyan Ji Anand Ji, you really have to create your own unique style. And I suppose it was the necessity that made R.D. go and fetch new sounds. The way the song has to be mixed, the way new instruments need to be pulled in to compose a track. All of this made R.D.'s music very novel, very different than what the rest of the musicians were doing. And I suppose he struck quite an awesome balance between keeping his roots with classical music intact, gathering new inspirations from the Western world and other forms of music.
हाँ, in fact, music directors में से वो तो पहले थे जिन्होंने गाने में कंघी की आवाज, ग्लास की, चम्मच की, डब्बे की, ये सब इस्तेमाल की, and that was a lot of fun altogether for the listeners also, क्योंकि वो चाहे वो किसी भी क्लासिकल रागा पे बेस्ड हो, एक आम सुनने वाले को उसमें अलग ही मजा आने लगा जो पहले कभी नहीं मिला था.
That's right. और उसी के साथ he also gave Indian audiences a glimpse of the way music is composed in the Western world as well. एक गाने की झलकी सुनते हैं और फिर आगे बात करते हैं.
If it's Tuesday, this must be Belgium. If it's Wednesday, this must be Rome. If it's Thursday, this must be Montreal. I fear I never wanna go home.
This song was the title track from the movie If It's Tuesday, It Must Be Belgium. तो ये गाना सुन के आप जान ही चुके होंगे कि हम किस गाने की बात कर रहे हैं.
धुन ऐसी है कि सबके जहन में बैठ चुकी है और वो गाना तो हम सब जानते ही हैं, चुरा लिया.
जी, एंड द यूज ऑफ गिटार, सैक्सोफोन एंड द वे ही हैज गॉट आशा जीज वॉइस, ऑल ऑफ इट पुट टुगेदर मेक्स दिस सॉन्ग सच अ टाइमलेस ब्यूटी.
This song and every song, in fact, इतने सारे गाने जो इस घंटे में हमने सुने आज, हर एक अपने आप में एक नगीना है. और आज ये भी पता चला surprisingly कि किस तरह से classical रागा based ये गाने हैं जिनके बारे में हमें कोई idea ही नहीं थी. That is an eye-opener as well. तो बढ़ते हैं इस गाने की ओर, जो कि है 1973 की फिल्म यादों की बारात से, जिसमें आवाज है आशा भोसले और मोहम्मद रफी साहब की. तो सुनिए अगला गाना और याद करें इस महान कलाकार को, राहुल देव बर्मन।
नहीं चुराना सनम।